Today's program will be presented in Malay and English with subtitles in Arabic, Malaysian, also known as Vietnamese, Chinese, Dutch, English, French, German, Hebrew, Hindi, Hungarian,
Indonesian,
Italian, Japanese, Korean, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Spanish, Thai, Urdu, and Turkish.
More languages are available online. For your special language, please visit www.screenmastertv.com/subtitles.
Salam mesra, penonton-penonton yang murah hati. Nama saya Tausen, dari Johor Bahru, Malaysia. Rakyat kami mengucapkan semoga anda dicurahi kasih sayang dan berkat dari syurga. Dalam episod hari ini, kami mempersembahkan kepada anda bahagian satu, Kubat Mahaguru Ching Hai yang bertajuk Kasih Sayang ialah inti pati hidup yang sebenar. Malaysia memang sebuah negara indah yang dikurniai dengan pelbagai bukit dan gunung yang ditumbuhi hutan tebal. Bentangan pantai yang dipinggiri pokok palma dengan laut yang kehijau-hijauan. Cahaya matahari keemasan serta lagun air tawar. Tarikan utama Malaysia ialah kontrasnya yang besar, iaitu dari pencakar langit yang mencuat tinggi dapat dilihat rumah papan yang dibina di atas kaki bajang. Budaya mazmot keajaiban alam semula jadi. Bandar raya besar dan banyak pulau yang indah permai. Semuanya sebahagian daripada negara yang indah ini. Populasi Malaysia kebanyakannya ialah orang Melayu, diikuti oleh orang Cina dan India. Budaya mazmot ini telah banyak mempengaruhi seni bina dan budaya negara ini. Dicerminkan melalui bangsa dan warisan yang pelbagai. Malaysia ialah negara asal banyak tokoh berani dan mulia. Pada bulan November tahun 2006, Datuk Muhammad bin Ismail telah dianugerahi hadiah keamanan gusi untuk hak ehwal keagamaan dan kemanusiaan. Dan bekas Perdana Menteri Tun Dr. Mahathir bin Mohamad telah dicalonkan untuk hadiah keamanan Nobel tahun 2007. Disebabkan oleh kegairahan para pencari spiritual, Mahaguru Ching Hai telah menerima undangan ikhlas mereka dengan berkunjung ke Malaysia sebanyak beberapa kali. Sekarang kami menjemput anda untuk mengikuti khutbah yang berikut oleh Mahaguru Ching Hai. Bertajuk Kasih Sayang ialah inti pati hidup yang sebenar. Disampaikan pada 30 hari bulan April tahun 2000 di Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
Ladies and gentlemen, many of us have long searched and have come here today full of hope. For those who have earnestly seek for the truth, it will be music to your ear to know that this search is over. Before us stand the Supreme Master Ching Hai, who has traveled a very long distance to be here. She seek nothing from us, not fame nor fortune. The only thing she asks is that we be faithful to our meditation and that we do no harm to others nor to ourselves. Please listen in a way that we have never listened before, for the Supreme Master bring us a message of love. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Supreme Master Ching Hai.
Thank you so much. May God bless you and your country. It's a very beautiful country. Very beautiful. Very clean and very prosperous. Today I have traveled along from the airport to the city. It's been a long time since I came to Malaysia. And your country has improved. More buildings, more prosperity, and everything is better. I'm very happy. I told the taxi driver, I'm so happy for your people. Even though it's not my physical country. But when I see people here happy and live in such a abundant, free life, I was feeling very, very happy, as if I am a Malaysian myself. It was truly like that. We have to be grateful to God, to Buddha, to Allah, that have blessed our country so much and blessed the people here so much. People here are very disciplined and very highly elevated. So I was thinking, what am I doing here? You are all Buddhas already.
Pada hari ini, saya amat bersyukur dan amat gembira karena dapat bersama anda. Dan hari ini juga saya merasa amat bangga dengan keadaan di negara ini, walaupun saya bukan seorang yang berbangsa Malaysia, tetapi saya merasakan yang diri saya memang bertuah dapat bersama anda di sebuah negara yang begitu bersih, indah dan menjelmakan satu keagamaan dan sifat kerohanian yang sebegitu baik. Dan semoga Tuhan merahmati limpah kurnia-Nya kepada anda semua. Terima kasih.
Wow. I'm very, very honored to be back in Malaysia again. And thank you, thanks God first, and thank to all our brothers and sisters in Malaysia who has been so gracious, so generous to have invited us here and to have worked very hard to make this evening a realization of love and dedication to God and mankind. Please thank them for me also. Not only the brother and sister in Malaysia, there are from Taiwan, from America, from Australia, from Singapore, Thailand, from Japan. So many nationalities have come here and to help to prepare this evening. We also thank them equally. Because we are brothers and sisters, we are in fact one. So no matter what we do for each other, it is the same as we do for ourselves. Because we love each other. That's the essence of life. The essence of life is love. The essence of God Buddha, of Allah, is love. There's nothing else but love.
Perasaan kasih sayang adalah perasaan yang harus dilimpahkan kerana itu adalah sebenar-benarnya perasaan yang diluahkan atau dilimpahkan oleh Tuhan kepada kita semua.
When we make the choice of love, that's the highest choice, the most, the noblest choice, which is our true self. We will feel that we are very near to God, very near to Buddha.
Apabila kita memilih perasaan kasih sayang adalah perasaan yang paling mulia, yang paling mendekatkan kita dengan diri Tuhan.
There are many choices we can make in life, and depends on what choice we make, we will become that being that represent the choice.
Kita mempunyai banyak pilihan dalam hidup, tetapi pilihan yang kita membuat akan menjadikan diri kita dan mencerminkan siapakah diri kita yang sebenarnya.
Over time, again and again, we keep making different choices. To be human being, to be angel, to be devas, to be one with God, or yet again come back to human life in order to remember again or relearn again the whole process.
Dari masa ke semasa kita banyak membuat pilihan sama ada untuk menjadi manusia, untuk menjadi malaikat, untuk menjadi apa sahaja dan supaya kita dapat belajar bersama dan juga dapat mencorakkan hidup kita bersama.
And when we remember, when we relearn again that we are from God, that we have Buddha nature, that we have the Holy Spirit that lives within ourselves, at that time we say that we are enlightened.
Apabila kita menghayati diri kita yang sebenarnya dan mendapat tahu yang ketuhanan atau kerohanian sebenarnya bermula dalam diri kita, sebenarnya kita telah menerima satu penghayatan yang baru.
There are many scriptures, many holy teaching from the past masters have told us that we are children of God, that we are one with God, that we are the Buddha, etc., etc., and every one of us know that. But to remember is a different thing.
Banyak ajaran-ajaran agama dan mereka-mereka yang telah wafat yang telah mencurahkan kepada kita apakah sebenarnya ajaran yang sebenarnya kita ini adalah milik Tuhan, anak Tuhan, sama atau bersatu sebagai Tuhan. Tapi kita telah melupakan dan kita selalu sering sahaja melupakan diri kita.
To remember our holy quality, our godly nature, is not by talking, is not by listening, is not by just believing, it is by knowing, it is by seeing, it is by truly experiencing. Then we really know.
Untuk menghayati sesuatu, ini bukan sahaja satu percayaan, kepercayaan, tetapi kita harus tahu, kita harus mengalami di dalam diri kita dan kita harus menghayati dan kemudiannya kita akan mendapat tahu yang bahawa ianya adalah sejati.
Because just to talk about love, we would not know love. Just to talk about water, we would not taste the water. Just to talk about sugar, sweetness, we will not know what it is unless we truly drink the water, eat the sugar, taste the flavor ourselves. At that time, that is a true knowing.
Kerana kita tidak akan tahu apa itu kasih sayang, seumpama kita tidak akan tahu bagaimanakah kita harus membuat atau kita harus tahu bagaimanakah rasanya air atau gula sehingga kita benar-benar merasai apa itu gula atau apakah itu kemanisan yang terdapat di sebalik gula tersebut. Sebegitulah kita akan tahu selepas kita menikmati rasa itu.
You see, I am so happy, I'm so excited, and I'm so amazed that you are all God, that you are all Buddha, and yet some of us don't know.
saya begitu asyik kerana anda semua adalah prinsip ketuhanan. Anda semua adalah Tuhan di dalam diri anda sendiri. Tetapi anda masih tidak tahu apakah diri anda sebenarnya.
To know God, to know yourself is as if you just turn the palm. That's it. It's just like looking in the front or looking to the back. Looking to the front, we see God, we see ourselves. Looking backward, we just see a mundane human mortal being.
Untuk mengetahui Tuhan adalah sebegitu senang, seumpama menoleh atau memusingkan tapak tangan kita, atau melihat ke depan dan ke belakang, dan melihat ke depan kita melihat diri kita sendiri atau diri Tuhan itu sendiri, dan melihat ke belakang atau menoleh ke belakang kita hanya melihat satu jasad yang sebegitu biasa atau mempunyai hanya kebiasaan sahaja.
I don't know how to explain this. I love you so much because you give me this realization that you are really God. It's so simple. It's so simple. You can erase this knowledge.
Sebenarnya ia adalah sebegitu mudah kerana ia bukannya sesuatu yang benar-benar susah, kerana ia adalah kebenaran hidup yang tidak boleh dipalsukan atau tidak boleh dilupakan semata-mata begitu sahaja.
And yet you have chosen to ignore it. You have chosen to forget that you are God, that you are Buddha.
Dan namun begitu anda telah melupakan atau tidak menghiraukan yang anda adalah benar-benar Tuhan atau sifat ketuhanan berada di dalam diri anda sendiri.
Do I make myself clear? Do you understand what I say?
Adakah saya benar-benar menjelaskan diri saya dengan benar kepada diri anda?
Yeah, at least you accept that you are God. Thanks God.
Sekurang-kurangnya anda menganggap diri anda sebagai diri ketuhanan.
But now if you just turn around, then you know immediately that you are God.
Dan sekiranya anda menoleh atau berpaling kepada diri anda, anda akan mengetahui yang anda sebenarnya Tuhan.
I know, even though I say that, I know it is difficult. But it's not impossible.
Saya tahu ianya mungkin mustahil atau susah, tetapi ia bukan sebegitu mustahil yang anda sangkakan.
If I can know this, you can.
Sekiranya saya boleh tahu kebenaran ini, anda juga boleh.
If our brothers and sisters initiate can, you can.
Jika semua saudara-saudari kita yang telah menerima inisiasi boleh, anda juga boleh.
Because there's nothing else but God within ourselves. All the scriptures say that.
Sebenarnya tidak ada apa-apa lagi kecuali ketuhanan di dalam diri kita, dan semua kitab-kitab agama menceritakan.
Now it's just up to us to try to remember or not, and I'm here to help you to remember.
Terpulanglah kepada diri anda sehingga anda ingin mengingati dan menghayatinya atau tidak, dan saya berada di sini untuk membantu anda untuk menghayati pengalaman ini.
God is the light that is brighter than thousands of suns put together. God is the melody that filled our souls with all happiness and contentment, no matter where we are and what race of nationality and what kind of background, what kind of religions we have.
Tuhan adalah umpama cahaya yang boleh meliputi beribu-ribu jenis jutaan atau berjuta-juta jenis cahaya matahari yang berkilau di dalam diri kita, dan juga irama-irama yang begitu asyik atau mengasyikkan di dalam diri kita yang tidak mengenali bangsa, agama maupun keturunan yang kita dapati.
And if we want to touch God as one of us, he even manifests as one of us. For example, Jesus, Buddha, Muhammad, the Sikh Guru, the Krishna Master, these are all the personally, individually manifestation of God for us to love, to see, to look, to touch, to believe.
Tuhan juga menjelma dalam berbagai-bagai jenis jelmaan yang kita kehendaki sebagai Nabi Isa, Nabi Muhammad,
Krishna dan sebagainya, sebagai Buddha dan sebagainya, supaya kita dapat mengingati dan supaya kita boleh menyentuh beliau sebagai prinsip atau sifat ketuhanan yang sebegitu mulia sekali.
And we still can contact these masters when we raise our consciousness to their dimension, which is higher than this physical consciousness of this planet.
Dan kita masih boleh berhubung dengan semua nabi-nabi dan kesemua yang telah menerima wahyu sebegini dengan menjadikan tahap fikiran kita kepada satu tahap yang lebih tinggi daripada tahap fizikal yang kita ada pada diri kita sekarang ini.
If I can, you can. If our brothers and sisters initiate can, you can. It happened now. It's not 1,000 years before.
Sekiranya saya boleh, anda boleh. Sekiranya saudara-saudari kita yang telah menerima inisiasi boleh, anda juga boleh. Dan ini bukannya berlaku 1,000 tahun yang lampau, tetapi berlaku sekarang di sini juga.
Because the good news is that we are one of this system. We are one with this godliness. We are one with everything that we see and we dream of, we can imagine, we are that.
Kerana berita baik adalah kita bersama-sama mereka pada waktu ini dan akan sentiasa bersama-sama walaupun di dalam mimpi, di dalam fikiran kita dan sebagainya. Kita boleh menghayati semuanya sebab ianya berada di dalam diri kita.
Just like we are one of the member of the audience in this hall, but yet we are also the whole with the whole gathering. We are individual, at the same time we are whole with the whole gathering of people here.
Seumpama kita berada sini sebagai seorang persendirian dan juga mampu menjadikan dewan ini penuh dan juga menjadi sebahagian daripada dewan ini, seumpama itulah kita bersama-sama dengan mereka setiap kali kita ingin atau menghayati.
So to see God, to know God, to talk to God even is a very normal thing for us.
Dan bertutur atau bercakap dengan Tuhan adalah amat senang kepada diri kita dan bukannya sebegitu susah yang kita sangkakan.
Okay, so now, because some of us have made many choices already, like, okay, sometimes we choose to be an ignorant person, sometimes we have chosen to forget that we are one with God, that God dwells within us. Sometimes we have chosen to do things that is even ungodly, so-called ungodly, or opposite of love, that we have chosen to do so many things. But maybe this is the time we have chosen to make a higher realization, higher remembrance of ourselves, because we have done all the lower part already.
Banyak di antara kita yang membuat banyak-banyak pilihan dan di antara pilihan-pilihan ini mungkin ada yang mencerminkan sifat-sifat yang kurang baik, sifat-sifat yang menolak kita daripada prinsip-prinsip kerohanian dan ketuhanan. Dan mungkin sekarang kita selepas melakukan sebegitu ingin menjadikan tahap kita sesuatu yang lebih baik atau meningkatkan tahap kecergasan dan minda kita supaya kita dapat membuat sesuatu yang boleh menjadikan kita seorang yang lebih baik.
So if you, the gracious brothers and sisters, choose to remember your great selves again, I'll be very honored to be of service. And this is the purpose of my coming here.
Where is the conscious? Where is the unconscious?
Where is the conscious? Where is the unconscious? It's all in here. It's all in ourselves.
Kesedaran dan keadaan tidak sedar adalah berada di dalam diri kita sendiri.
I wonder if you could satisfy my desire. I'm from China. I would like to see you.
See me in China? That's a very good request. You see, it's not a question of going there. It's a question of what can I do there. If I can see you there in all openness and friendliness like this, in your home, it's fine. It's not always possible in some place on this planet. So we shall be patient, huh?
Supaya dapat beliau pergi ke China dan memberikan khidmat beliau di sana, tetapi bukannya apa yang beliau boleh pergi ke sana, tapi apa yang beliau boleh lakukan di sana adalah lebih penting. Dan sekiranya anda mempunyai kesabaran tersebut.
Yeah, that's what I was saying today when I passed through the street of your country. I told the taxi driver, oh, such a free country, such a developed country. You have to really be grateful to be a Malaysian. I told him, you have to be proud to be a Malaysian. It's such a nice and free country. Everyone believes what they want, freedom of everything. And, you know, you're really taken care of here, and the country is so clean and nice. It's not that you always can be born in such a country, I told him. And he was so happy. He said, yes, yes, I take it for granted. But it is so, it is so. Malaysia is good, good, he said too. Yes.
Malaysia adalah satu negara yang begitu hebat, begitu baik, begitu membangun dan mempunyai kepercayaan. Semua orang diberi kebebasan untuk memilih kepercayaan mereka sendiri, dan kita harus bangga, kita harus berbangga yang kita dilahirkan di sebuah negara yang mempunyai banyak nikmat-nikmat kemudahan dan sebagainya di sini. Dan sebagaimana yang kita selalu mengambil sikap sambil lewa, kita harus menghargai yang kita dapat dilahirkan di sebuah negara yang sebegitu cantik dan unik sekali.
When I travel alongside of the highway here, it looks like in Europe or America. The highway is so wide and so well looked after. Yes. Every country should be like this.
Lebuh raya-lebuh raya di sini adalah benar-benar hebat dan besar. Seumpama lebuh raya-lebuh raya di negara-negara barat seperti Eropah dan Amerika. Dan ia begitu mengagumkan dan mengasyikkan kepada semua.
Thank God. Thank God for your country.
Bersyukur kepada Tuhan kerana negara ini betul-betul hebat.
Dear Master, what does Master think of open eye meditation?
Well, I think it is an open eyes kind of meditation. That's what I think.
Ia adalah kaedah mata terbuka sahaja, itu sahaja.
You see, open eyes or closed eyes, it is better you have a meditation way that you can see your own nature or see God. It's not about the question of open or closed eyes. But I tell you why we close eyes is better, because it's better for concentration. Because we don't see well with the physical eyes, we have to see with the eye of the soul, with the wisdom eye. That is the real seeing. And suppose both eyes are functioning at the same time, it's also okay. But when we reach to that level, then we can even see God with open eyes too, without even sitting cross-legged in a cushion or anything. We can see him while driving, while washing dishes, washing clothes, or fetching the kids from the school, etc., etc. But in the beginning, it is better for us, for our concentration, if we shut down all the physical organs, like ears and eyes, to minimize the distraction of the world. Suppose I sit here, I say, okay, I'm going to meditate, but my eyes are open like this, and the brother coming up and the sister coming down and everything else is, you know, running around. It would be very difficult for me to concentrate in the beginning, yeah?
Dear Master, if God is all power, all everything, and so perfect, why doesn't he create a perfect world so that all human beings can live in heaven?
Why doesn't he create a better world, right? So all beings can live in peace together? Yes, yes, yes. Yes, then there'll be no fun, brothers. That's the purpose of creation. Suppose we all look alike. Have you seen the film called What Planet Do You Come From? Have you seen that film yet? It's not yet in Malaysia. Okay, we'll come later. It's a film is depicting that, and that, you know, it's kind of science fiction, but it could be true. As a planet where all men look alike, and no woman even. You like to be in sort of place like that? Just men, everything look the same? Everybody look the same? Every car look the same? Every house look the same? Every clothes look the same? Is it okay? Yeah, possible. Yes, there are choices, you see. If you like that kind of place, possible. Do the kind of meditation that we offer here, and you can make more choices. You see, right now, we don't have many choices because you forgot that you are God. You forgot that you are creator. You can create anything you want. You forgot this power. So go back to yourself, be enlightened, be your God self, and then you can create many things. So when you want a peaceful world, you can do that. You can ascend to a peaceful level of consciousness where everything is peaceful and not even one word of suffering is heard. There's no such thing as suffering in their dictionary, you see. But if we just stay here in this physical planet, then the only choice we have is whatever here, you see.
Kita mempunyai banyak pilihan di dalam hidup. Dan kita boleh memilih sama ada hendak menjadi seorang yang melihat penderitaan ini atau kita boleh membangkitkan diri kita kepada satu tahap yang lebih baik di mana semua yang hidup bersama kita tidak ada penderitaan dan selalu mengalami hanya kegembiraan dan kebaikan di dalam hidup masing-masing. Dan kaedah yang kami gunakan di sini adalah salah satu daripada kaedah yang boleh membawa anda kepada tahap tersebut. Kita melupakan diri kita dan kita telah melupakan yang kuasa yang kita ada adalah kuasa yang paling mutlak, kuasa yang diberikan oleh Tuhan kerana kita adalah Tuhan tersebut. Dan apabila kita menggunakan kaedah ini untuk mengembalikan diri kita ke kaedah tersebut, kita boleh melakukan apa sahaja yang kita impikan.
Yes. In the creation, there are many, many levels. Like in the Bible, Jesus said that in the house of my Father, there are many mansions. The mansions are the depiction of the consciousness level. Here we are in a physical consciousness, so we think ourselves as a human being. And there's no other choice, no other access to us, either to heaven or so-called hell. But if we use the other road, the soul road, we can ascend to heaven, see different levels of living beings, and we can even descend to hell to help some people who suffer there and bring them up. These are choices that we have when we attain enlightenment.
Ini adalah salah satu pilihan yang kita boleh. Seumpama Nabi Isa berkata di dalam kitab Injil, di rumah ayah saya, ayahanda saya, terdapat banyak mahligai-mahligai. Ini adalah tahap-tahap kesedaran yang kita ada dalam diri kita. Dan apabila kita membangkitkan diri kita dari satu tahap ke tahap yang lain, kita boleh melihat kebaikan-kebaikan yang berlaku. Dan kita boleh juga melihat apakah bezanya di antara syurga dan neraka. Dan kita boleh memberikan pertolongan kepada mereka yang berada di dalam keadaan neraka dan membawa mereka ke keadaan syurga dengan menggunakan kaedah-kaedah yang kami ajar ini.
Thank you. Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Kami berbesar hati adanya anda bersama kami untuk episod hari ini. Kasih sayang ialah inti pati hidup yang sebenar. Bahagian 1, Seri Berdua, dalam rancangan kata-kata bijaksana. Alan Turing, jenius keaslian yang terkemuka, akan disiarkan seterusnya. Teruslah bersama Supreme Master Television. Semoga kebijaksanaan Tuhan membimbing setiap langkah anda dalam kehidupan. It has been a pleasure to have you with us for today's episode of Love is the True Essence of Life, Part 1 of 2, on Words of Wisdom, Alan Turing and Outstanding Genius of Great Originality is up next. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. May the wisdom of heaven guide your every step through life. For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/WOW.
Ingrid Newkirk, Supreme Master Televisions. You are a force of good in the world. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Erin Cummings. You're watching Supreme Master Television. Be veg, go green, save the planet.
My deep appreciation and congratulations to Supreme Master Television.
My name is Brendan Brazier. Be veg, go green, save the planet.
This is Ed Begley. Be veg, go green, to save the planet.
I'm Loretta Devine. You're watching Supreme Master Television. Have a good time.
Hey, this is Wayne Brady, and you are watching Supreme Master Television.
Hello, my name is Stephanie Powers, and you're watching Supreme Master Television.
Hi, I'm Amber Stevens. Be veg, go green, save the planet. Thanks for watching.
Welcome.
I'm John Sally, and I want to say to Supreme Master TV, thank you for being the source of knowledge for those who want to go green, for those who are being vegans, and thank you for the Supreme Master.
This is Kenneth G. Williams saying, be veg, go green, save the planet.
The Supreme Master Television presents the truth, and nothing but the truth, to lift up the faith of the people to prosperity and justice.
Everyone, big and small, young and old, go green, be a veg.